In this lesson, we're going to look at the definition of entropy, and we're also going to learn how to predict whether entropy is increasing or decreasing for a reaction. And we're going to look at this qualitatively, not quantitatively. Previously, we've talked about enthalpy, which is associated with heat. We talked about endothermic, where heat was going into the system, and so energy was consumed as part of the reaction, like in a cold pack. An exothermic system, such as a fire where the wood burning is releasing energy because heat is leaving the system. Entropy is a little different. One way to think about it is it's a measure of the disorder. And so if I look at two examples here, I look at the example on the left where I'm increasing the entropy, so I'm increasing the disorder in the system. I notice here that all of my molecules here on the left, the blue molecules and the red, are separated, so there's not lots of order there. When I release the valve in between the A and B sides of this container, I see that I get mixing to occur, and as a result, I'm increasing the entropy because I'm increasing the disorder in the system. Now, the picture on the right is representing the condensation of water. So if we have water in the gas phase, and then it begins to condense to the liquid phase, so we're going from gas to liquid, what we see is that we are decreasing the entropy, we are decreasing the disorder, because molecules in the liquid phase have a more ordered arrangement than they do in the gas phase. So let's look at some characteristic features of when we see both increases and decreases in entropy. So when we increase entropy, we are increasing the disorder of the system. And when we typically see this in phases is when we go from solid to liquid to gas. Remember that in a solid, molecules are ordered and arranged very specifically. As we go to a liquid, the molecules can now move around more and there's less order. When we go to a gas, we see much more disorder because their molecules have no specific set arrangement. We also see increases in entropy when we dissolve a solid in water. We go from having a solid such as NaCl, which has a very ordered crystalline structure, to being dissolved in water. So now the sodium and chloride ions are separated from one another, and they're spread out and mixed in with the water molecules. We also see an increase with an increase in temperature. As we increase the temperature, the speed of the molecules moves more, and we tend to see that they are more disorderly arranged or less ordered in their arrangement as they move faster. We also see, when we look at a reaction, if we look at an increase in the number of gas phase species. So if we increase the number of gas phase species, so for example, having one gas phase species on the left side of the reaction versus two on the right, we see an increase in entropy for that reaction. Now let's look at some examples for decreases in entropy, and so these are increases in order. So we are decreasing the disorder or increasing the order. So as we go from a gas to a liquid to a solid, we become more ordered in the arrangement of the atoms, and so we are decreasing the change in entropy. If ions are precipitating as a solid, so basically the opposite of dissolving a solid in water, if we have ions mixed in with water molecules, then precipitate out as a solid, we're going to see a decrease in the entropy. If we decrease the temperature, we slow down the molecules, we're more likely to go into a lower disordered phase or a more ordered phase. And we also see the molecules slow down, they're more likely to be in some ordered arrangement. We also see it when we have a decrease in the number of gas phase species. So all of these are basically opposites of one another. And when we go to fewer gas phase species, we see that we have a more ordered arrangement. So we have a decrease in entropy. So let's look at some examples and see how we will analyze these. Which change will result in an increase in entropy? So let's look at a couple of them together before you try one on your own. For NaCl, we see it's in the solid phase, and then it goes to the aqueous phase, which means it's dissolved in water. Therefore, this will be an increase in entropy. For B, we see going from a liquid to a solid, so we're going to decrease the entropy because we're increasing the order. And next, we see going from a gas to a liquid. And so when we go from a gas phase to a liquid, we see that's a decrease in entropy.